Healing
It's
ward
time to
is
pick.
pretty decent, so your pusher, like Juggernaut, doesn't get destroyed. You have to heal up. So I think it's he's pretty good, and he can actually deal with blinding light too, getting out of it or whatever it may be.
10 seconds. Overall, a good core, really, in many cases. But yeah, justification as to why against the Coddle, as well, being brought up there. The fourth picks for either side now coming out for these teams. And I will say, Insania loves to play Rubick. So I wouldn't be surprised if that's a pick up here. Now, is there a reason why Rubick would be a bad pick, you think?
I don't think it particularly deals well with Bounty Hunter or Embers. I think you either want a hero that can just, like, destroy the Bounty Hunter on sight, or a hero that provides more lockdown versus Embers. I mean, Rubick's never, like, I wouldn't say he's ever never a bad pick, but I would say they're a better pick.
Yeah. Well, Secret's spending quite a bit of time, actually, with this fourth pick. I mean, you figure they still need their one in their offlane, most likely, so... Ooh! A little different. Chaos Knight.
They have no AoE.
Maybe that's why.
Chaos Knight actually has mana issues. For Chakra, you, like, treads armlet, and... This stuns a lot of mana. 140, and then your reality rifting a lot.
10 seconds remaining.
One of those cores is like, you used to build drums for the mana, but now drums are scrapped, so not that many great items. You can build Helm, but Helm's like not that great on him. Talked about it.
There we go. I know my boy well.
Rubick, hit it.
Rubick coming out here, yeah, and Sania loves to play that. And come with me, the other support player, and we do see that Wisp ban, by the way. Quick note on that. That's Team Secret doing a little bit of research in the open qualifiers, because we cast these guys later on, and I think it was a semifinal matchup, actually. Come with me, dominated with a Wisp. It was actually really crazy to see, using that Spirits to do plenty of damage throughout early ganks, and then obviously with the Tether and the relocate to certain positions to save and also play offense. It was just crazy how well he was playing it. So, understandable that they ban out a comfort hero clearly there.
I think they know him personally, too. Come with me, he's been in the scene forever. Come with Garter and Cheshire Cat. They've been, like, on the tier, like, 3-ish or forever. You just meet him a lot in pubs or random small tournaments all the time. Whatever it may be. Chaos Knight's cool, though.
Yeah, that's pretty unique, too, and fun to watch. He is he can be entertaining. Yeah, Reality Rift pull in. Stun that he brings, and then his ulti, of course, with the Illusion Creation of the Phantasm here. Lacking AoE, though, as you're talking about, like, on the other side. Again, Rubick doesn't really... I guess the Fade Bolt can be decent, but... Is that going to be an overall concern, you feel like, for Pro Dota right now?
Oh, definitely. Chaos Knight is always an issue. You don't have any AoE. Invoker is one of the best ones, because Illusions can't... And if you get, like, if you get Armlet Heart on CK, you need a way to deal with that. Invoker is one of the better ones. Deafening Blast is really good at dealing with Illusions. Bench Immunity, Ice Wall. All these are really good. But other than that, what's a mid hero with AoE that can deal with Chaos Knight? That's not Timber Assault or Invoker.
OD?
OD is kinda. Okay, but you have to have BKB to deal with it.
Yeah.
Which is not ideal. Magnus maybe might be an option. That's very risky. I don't like it really for certain lineup. I think Empowered Jug is so Turtles would be good.
I mean, likes to play Storm Spirit, but that is obviously one of those bans there.
And they need a good lane versus Ember. Maybe they just put Jug mid.
Like a TA or a Phantom Assassin, something like those routes. But...
TA would get dumpstered so hard. Oh my god.
I'm just throwing out random heroes here, alright.
What was the other one?
Phantom Assassin.
Ooh, Phantom Assassin would also get dumpstered. Shadow Fiend is nice. Very good option. It's like a strong mid laner that scales that has some AoE. That's a good BKB hero. I think they need a BKB.
Yeah. That almost seemed like an obvious pick, actually. I'm surprised now that one of us even brought that up, but...
Yeah.
So many heroes in this damn game. But yeah, definitely one of our obvious ones, and we have been seeing a lot of Shadow Fiend come back on the scene recently, so... Not surprising to see that here. Final pick.
It's really tough for Bounty Hunter. Bounty Hunter, Shadow Fiend. Oh, okay. Might be... Off.
Ezu, Enigma.
First Rubick, too. And Nightstalker. That's not easy.
Yeah.
That's a real tough Enigma game. But...
This is like the fourth Enigma game I've seen in these last 2 days. I don't know if it's starting to be a trend or something, but...
Enigma is very good in my opinion. I think he... Like, not nearly as good as Kato, but I would definitely... Rubik's like picked so commonly now. Some of the scenes, Warlock is also kind of common too. Enigma doesn't very do well versus many of those. Same with Corvenge, I also think is kind of popular, and
oh yeah,
there's just no way to deal with
it. Yeah. Fun fact here, as we're loading into the game now, as far as a little bit of history with some of these players here. Keizu, as I mentioned, may be playing the Enigma, but Keizu, actually former teammates with Insania and Mikke back in their Han days, so they do have a little bit of personal history there. They know each other very well, and we're successful together, so it's kind of fun seeing them in a matchup against one another now over here, of course, Dota 2, and a pretty prestigious event, to say the least, the EU qualifier, so looking forward to this one quite a bit. But again, Secret in a lot of people's minds. Talking about that real quickly, I mean, do you feel like Secret's probably the team to beat in the European region? For these qualifiers.
I think so. Yeah. Of any other...
I guess...
The best ones.
Some of the other favorites, like Bears, I know, has been getting
Bears
a lot of attention.
Good.
Yeah.
I think Bears and Secret.
Yeah.
But there can only be one.
That's true. For Europe, there can only be one. A couple of regions have two, but...
Ooh,
Southeast
double
Asia.
Mangoes on MP. Mango man.
All right, likes those mangoes there.
You don't see mangoes much anymore.
No.
Mangoes are not very common. You see one on Jug a lot of the time. Other than that, you don't see mangoes. But he has Keeper on his team, too, which is even more surprising. Puppy will actually be taking the Bounty Hunter. Puppy, or Twilight I won't be taking. Twilight usually plays a four.
Never see, especially two mangoes. I mean, it feels like that means that he's going to be looking to be very aggressive with his abilities, of course, right? Like, especially that Chaos Bolt.
Yeah, you usually get Clarities, though. But
yeah.
Clarities are so valuable now. Oh, my goodness. 90, man.
Can't be taken off by creeps now as well. That's a nice benefit. Especially for junglers that are not a thing, really. And even with these Enigma pickups, it's like the fourth game I've happened to see him in completely different teams. He's always in the offlane, though. He's never actually been a jungle Enigma.
Lose the lanes, lose the game.
Okay. That's important. Those good old lanes. Puppy is on the Bounty Hunter here, and he's at the top lane, ready to harass with the Enigma up here and harass some of the supporting cast, I'm sure.
He also wanted to block that big spawn. If Enigma is going to be jungling and ditch the off lane, then they want someone to soak it up and to make sure that they don't play super. Super Greedy is stacking and pulling both the large camp and the small camp. It can't stack the large camp. They're actually not getting that much out of it if Enigma's able to creep into the jungle. And Puppy is still getting speed. I actually think Secret went out in this.
Yeah.
And he denied the range creep.
So bottom lane, though, I mean, this is interesting with they do send Night Stalker bottom. He's kind of partnered with a Slaughter, but it seems a little awkward almost. He going up against Chaos Knight, Coddle, already a lot of pressure on a Night Stalker. Is this going to be an issue for Night Stalker, you feel?
Yes. Laning versus Keeper.
Always going to be an issue.
Keeper is incredibly difficult. Especially at this level with these Keepers. Like, the way they jungle... And the way they like blast from the fog is just—it's just really difficult. Can't really dodge it if they're really good about their blast. Pylon is one of the better support players, I would say, in the EU region. I don't know. The things that you can do with Keeper is just for.
Yeah. And Slaughter—he's running on the uphill. Come with me. Needs to be careful about that. Of course, Chaos are there pinging out as if they want to make a play. He does have the combo, the Reality Rift, and the Chaos Bolt. So. Going back to Coddle,
you can't contest the pull. Like he can just blast
yeah.
this, and then you take damage and he gets a creep. Like how do you stop that? You just can't. Like even Cheshire Cat tried to come around and maybe interrupt it with a void, but it doesn't really matter. Like I don't know. Keepers.
Well, we're not talking about Keeper enough, so I want to keep talking about it here. But the lack of mana leak being picked up lately by a lot of Keeper players earlier on in the game, I feel like has kind of been a trend, too. Have you noticed that?
Screw mana leak. 150
yeah?
mana. Especially if you dual lane. Like, if they dual lane, you can just stand there. It's not...
Okay.
Because dual lanes have been very popular now. So, I think if it's like a solo offlaner, especially some of the weak ones, maybe... Like Centaur too, Centaur's been pretty common, then I think it's okay. But I think Chakra just wins your lane a lot more along with the Illuminate. Because, like, mana leak, you can't contest a neutral. A lot more flexible. He didn't get the small camp double stack off because the slaughter blocked it, so this stack's was slowing him down a decent amount, not being able to get. They're bringing Puppy in down here, and it is just a solo Night Stalker, sort of wrapping around mid lane. Mid one a little bit low, but it's going to be really hard unless he gets like a double tango into a stun.
Yeah.
Ooh, really tough. And he has to not use his chain.
That's true, yeah.
And not bottle up. Yeah, it's
just a lot of things need to work out for Come With Me there, but he is being patient. I mean, he's chilling nearby. He wants to get it, but meanwhile, bottom lane. We do have the actual first blood coming out onto Night Stalkers. He goes down. You mentioned Puppy going in there earlier on, and it was just about a matter of time before they eventually got it. Now Slaughter is going to be found, and mid one will be fine as a result. So
they knew that Slaughter was around because no one helped the Night Stalker just die. So what is Slaughter doing? Either jungling, taking bounty runes, or harassing mid. He doesn't have iron talent, so he's not jungling. He's not close to the 4 minute mark, so he's not taking bounties. So only other place for him.
Still look at Night Stalker too, yeah, again with the double mango on him as well, ready to regen kicking in, but doesn't really have the opportunity to use them necessarily as Bounty Hunter, gonna keep roaming around of course, going up here trying to find that Slaughter, not gonna find him though as he's running the other direction picking up that bounty rune, towards the middle instead.
Puppy is trying to keep tabs on the Slaughter, he knew that he took the bounty rune, or was it around that area? And there is a smoke. Is he going to pop it? He immediately popped it. You have a dust, Puppy.
Okay. This
he
could be a turn.
Wondering how the hell they knew he was there. But he will at least pop Clarity. Oh, he actually might get away.
No. Oh, he missed the crush. And now the turn. Okay, there you get it.
He got a raise, too. He dragged him closer to tower. That was actually pretty cool.
Yeah.
By Insania. Give him that little bit of extra true sight by dragging closer to tower.
There. Oh, middle lane actually. Mid one could go down. The second raid's connect. There's a void coming out for the Night Stalker, and down he goes. It is nighttime. And they take advantage of that immediately. So that's a great rotation. Of course, what you like to see with the first nightfall, especially.
Yeah, they're making really good use of the offlanes because they know they can't really stop the pulls and they can't really stop Chaos Knight from farming. So they relegated it to at least try and win the mid lane. I think they would have tried to smoke around mid two before the Ember Spear hit. But unfortunately, that window is going to close very soon. Despite it still being nighttime for 3 minutes, Ember Spear is almost sick. Almost
there. Chaos Knight level 5. He still has both those mangoes. That's where it feels like, almost like, I guess in hindsight, maybe it wasn't necessary to get the two mangoes. But, you know, it's probably the health regen, I guess.
The health regen's good. I think it's quite good. Because Hedra, Ring is 2 regen for, almost 3 times the gold. Kind of value.
Oh man, they're trying to make a decision to go in up here, but he chooses to fall back, and now Come With Me is going to fall as a result of that. Yeah, that was Juggernaut was going back and forth. He's like, I want to dive with you, bro, but I also don't want to. He chose not to.
Maybe he were sick. They made it quick and clean. Fortunately, he is not. Bounty Hunter, is he going to get the chicken's kill? Oh,
no.
He knows it's around there, and Bruno also knows.
Sit in the trees. Obviously, when you're going against a bounty hunter, you really have to keep tabs on that courier. Especially with Puppy playing it, he's known for hunting those couriers, and not gonna get that one there though. So
try to use a skin. Is he gonna walk into it?
Here comes the silence though, and now Ember Spirit, level 6, but with the silence, of course, unable to use the remnant, and he will go down. So
that was a really good use of skin too. They knew that. The Slaughter was like, I'm not sure if he knows that I'm here or not, so rather than dusting prematurely or dropping a sentry, they use a skin to make sure that their presence is that was really cool.
Good heads up there from Pro Dota, and well, 3-2 lead, obviously they're addressing this Ember Spirit in the middle lane as he's now 0-2-0, so kind of keeping him in check, and it most certainly is working as, oh, they're collapsing on the Caudal right here as a lift coming out from Insania, throws him down to Crush. It did actually hit, that was pretty far distance, but they do connect, they get the kill on Akado, now they need to run, that's going to be a lot easier said than done. The Black Hole comes out, and there's no stopper despite being nearby, but the damage coming out from Mickey, as Sutter gets pulled back in, the double kill for mid one, but he's being turned on now, the Omni Slash bouncing in the background, gets the kill onto him, and Puppy, gonna pop that Shadow Walk away and be fine, but, well, numbers-wise, that worked out for Pro Dota, looks like.
They are making so much happen during the nighttime, too. That was a pretty decent black hole, but they didn't have enough burst into there. The Ember Spirit only had one remnant down there at the time, and Caudal was already dead, so they didn't have the Illuminate. CK didn't even TP, so great black hole, but no follow-up from them. And that was on their shrine. That was not a fight that they wanted to lose.
No.
But it is circling in on daytime, just about 10 seconds or so. And Pilot Eye will get the D ward, but this is not really the early game that Secret would have wanted. They definitely don't want an Ember Spirit with three deaths right now.
Yeah, it's pretty evident that of course, it's just they picked up Night Stalker maybe because Cottle was picked up on the other side, but at the same time, it wasn't just like a blind pickup of like, well, yeah, this is night against day.
Oh,
it's good.
Top lane, Kazu and Pilot Eye in a.
A Corrosive Haze just yet for Slaughter, so the amp damage not going to be working, but yeah, they're trying to set up here, but you can tell with hugging the tower, they know something's up. Pushing out now a little bit, though, so perhaps an opening to be had.
Yeah, they have to be very careful, though. One TP, I think, won't be probably too much for them to handle.
Oh, they're going to cut to the river, actually. Yeah, they know now. Casey realizing, crap, he's in a bad spot. Can he get the stun off? He cannot first. A nice blinding light pushback, though. He'll throw the stun on to come with me, and that's going to be enough to scare him off. Illuminate from a distance from Cottle, and no kill on there as a result. Middle lane, meanwhile, they do get the kill on a mid game. They dive in pretty aggressively. Looks like Chaos Knight, of course, assisting with that. The Phantasm being used.
And good track job. Time.
And they're going to the top lane. Look at that. Juggernaut, he will maybe be able to spin out and TP away, but good movement here coming out from the Radiant side now. Oh, dust on Puppy, but a little too far away. As that track is put up.
Get out of there. Track move speed.
Oh. He's good. And at the top lane, again, he got recalled up here by Cottle after that middle cove pretty much right away, and now going to play aggressive at the top lane. So this Chaos Knight, he's definitely being aggressive with the team as Puppy. He's making his way up here, too. He notices Garner running up here in the Juggernaut as well as Cheshire Cat. Nice vision for the team. All five of them are collapsing in, though. There goes that track going to be wearing off now on a Slaughter. Trying to run away. Can he maybe get a Blindstone Enigma? Absolutely not. He ports out.
They also don't have positioning. Like, Keeper can't, like, blast into them because they're coming in from, like, three directions. Right side, the southeast side, and the south.
Yeah. So
that was definitely the right play to neck off.
Armlet being purchased here by MP, of course, playing the Chaos Knight.
Red's Armlet makes your illusions very strong, and it gives you a ton of armor versus the SF, Slaughter, and the Juggernaut. Overall, one of the better builds. Especially when you have Cottle.
Darkness has fallen as another relocate in, though, actually coming out, and Slaughter is going to feel the pain as a result. Chaos Knight getting pulled on in from Cottle and doing a lot of work in the background. Ember Spirit, he's chasing Insania. The Rubick will also be illuminated down, making it a 2-for-nothing. So again, great movement, a great response from Secret. Another relocate. They're really taking advantage of the recall, excuse me.
Yeah, Cottle. Keeper broken. Recall. It's like, oh, okay, I'm looking for the Cottle. Oh, wait, there's a CK there waiting for me. That must be fun.
Yeah, that ability. So bring him on in and ready to fight. And now this top tower, it's also ready to fall. No defense being put up by Protota. Understandable. Just going to let this one go up here, but help of the Dominator is being worked on by Carter. Again, a lot of fighting going on, so definitely a different game, as that was a Requiem used in the middle. Not really getting anything out of it, though. I don't know if Pilot Eye was walking in. He thought he had a chance right there, but now actually Puppy's going to be found. Sitting with the Invis on top, the track is up, though the Reality Rift pull in. There's a Phantasm, and they got the kill of Shadow Fiend. That's going to be big. A lot of gold going around.
Got two illusions.
Yeah.
That's a little bit too RNG for it's one of the more, I guess Chaos Knight, I mean, his name is Chaos.
That's the point.
That's probably one of the most RNG levels of the game.
And that's Chaos Knight in general. Yeah. Likes that RNG. Definitely it can work out as it did there, of course, though. And obviously Shadow Fiend feeling the pain. And by losing the tower, definitely a victory for Team Secret. So the early start with the rotations from Night Stalker was looking pretty good. But notice how, since it's been the next daytime, it's been the advantage for the other side. So it's going to be in shifts, it almost feels like.
Yeah, they have the holdout too, so they can still fight during night. Flag. Kezu also has his mech complete already. I wonder actually what Bounty Hunter is going to already have the mech. Maybe Solar Crest? Oh, Solar Crest is.
Yeah. Great item, amping that damage, but also the evasion. Nice benefit to have.
Roche.
Yeah. Ember Spirit, he gets caught up here. The net onto him, even as you see the come on the Dominator making use of that with the Dark Troll Summoner. But Carter realizing that more is nearby and he'll fall back. But how about this Ember Spear, by the way? He went right into bots here with the Ring of Aquila. No Veil pickup yet. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. That's like a spell
little,
amp.
It's definitely a little bit unusual, especially because he has Keeper. We've seen some of them go like Tread. Radiant's, I guess he's going to rely on the Chaos Knight to be in the front line and wants to up his heal a lot. The BOTs, maybe the recall for Chaos Knight.
Yeah. Got this push though from this Radiant side. It's definitely effective, and they get another tower kill as a result. And not much that, again, the Dire can do to stop it, it seems like, right now. But again, it is nighttime. Up though. Gonna scout out a couple over here. Another dust goes out though, but it was just out of range.
Top lane, ooh. From the fog. That was a very nice Chaos Bolt. He has a Chaos Bolt from like the southeast and then drug him into it. But those were trees over there, so he had no time to react with this.
Yeah, great catch there, and again, Puppy also gonna walk away with really no harm. He's continued to be a nuisance. He wanted to pick off that courier, but not gonna happen. But you can just tell the map control right now for Team Secret is definitely on point at this time. Point Booster already picked up by Caudle with that set, so the Axe is coming along very nicely. Arm right here as Insania's roaming on through. He actually stole the Shadow Walk, that's why he's in this. And nope, yeah, nice pilot. I actually snipes that bounty right in front of him, meanwhile. Able to get it right there. Shadow Fiend, though, what does he have? He has a Dragonlance, and he's working right into a BKB, so feel like he needs the combat items here. Ready to fight as top lane, no collapse on. Silence comes out on a Keeper of the Light, but in comes Ember Spirit. The Reality Rift pull back in the background. It will lock down for the kill to Night Stalker. Sodar, come with me, throws out a crush, but he just wants to run after that. Once again, the Reality Rift pulls him back in. The Track Hold coming out. Double kill for Puppy. And talk about excelling. They are definitely excelling now.
One thing that's also a sick combo with Keeper is like the, if you use the Chakra Magic on the Ember Spirit, you can double root them.
Oh, nice.
It is quite crazy.
Spin out there.
That was really nice chains by mid one. You got the double chains mid remnant onto two of the heroes. That was a high skill Ember in action.
Doing work here, and he has that Maelstrom coming along, so yeah, it's going to pass up the Villa Discord as a whole. It seems like maybe not as much of a fan as others. That tended to be over time, but again, that kind of seemed to be the flavor build for the post 7.0 for the longest, but...
Yeah, maybe because his other cores don't do that much magic damage. I think his Night Pulse is pure, and then Chaos Knight does very little magic damage. I mean, I think it's really good for like Keeper County though, but Maelstrom helps him farm up a lot. Huh?
What do we think of the choice to go right into the BKB here for Shadow Fiend post the Dragonlance?
I think he needs it versus the CK. CK would just blow you up. Like, there's nothing you can do as a Shadow Fiend versus a CK with Tread's Armlet. He just armlets, even if he only gets one illusion, like if he gets stunned, you're dead. You don't have no save on your team. I agree. It's gonna make him a little light on the damage, but that's what Amplify is for. They're giving up. They're hemorrhaging track kills.
I mean, look at how deep they are. It's all the way to the tier 3 just about.
Bounty Hunter and Keeper is just way too much map control.
Yeah.
Like, you see anyone that you want to kill, okay, BOT in, recall, and there's four people right there within 3 seconds.
That's just ridiculous. Behind a tier 2 tower, they can just do it so freely.
Shadow Fiend might die here. He has a hate.
Oh, he has an ace bottle. He has a double damage activated too, so the double rune, but... Not going to really get the benefit out of it, but yeah, with the Haste rune, hopefully he should be able to get away if he gets caught there, or ideally, I should say. As bottom lane, mid one, he's going to scare off Garner. Garner probably feels like, okay, yeah, Bounty Hunter could be nearby, and you always have to be guessing about that. They've definitely been feeling the pain as a result. Kids go over the top lane, trying to pick off Slaughter, but he cannot get close enough for that Malphus.
Another one of those games where Slaughter is not going to be able to get blink for a long time.
Yeah. Definitely having trouble with that. Shadow Fiend, he wants to make a play up here. They would love to kill Chaos Knight. Now comes across the face, like, all right, you want to fight? Let's fight, baby. The illusions come out with the Phantasm. There goes the Requiem of Souls, but down goes Sauter pretty quickly. MP, he's going to be lifted up, though. You see Enigma running in. He has a black hole ready to go, but it's going to be tough to get a good one off right there. Chaos Knight finally picked off. That's a nice bounty. Coming out for the other side, being Night Stalker, and the chase continues. Kazu, again, he has that black hole. Could set up a turn for perhaps if the support comes in, but... No, he's going to be silenced, and he will be nuked down with the Raze. Oh, Dota, that's a good victory for them.
That was bad communication from Team They, firstly, Recall was down. They didn't have the ultimate up on Keeper. And secondly, the Ember Spirit used his BOT to go home to get his Maelstrom. So they weren't able to bring the Ember Spirit at all, which would have been pretty good for them because he could have just changed them into a position where they could have gotten Black Cold for the Enigma, but they were just not on the same page.
Oh, they're running down Garter up here at the top lane. Out comes those chains, but gonna get the spin off. They know when it's down, though. He's gonna be pretty vulnerable right here. So the Mana Leak being used, the Heal War put down, but he's gonna take a stun from that Mana Leak. And the burn, baby, burn with the Remnant right in the face. So easy kill on a Juggernaut in the end.
Track gold.
Once again.
Track gold.
I wish there was a stat to like keep track of track gold.
Should be. One of these days, we'll get it. It's been a lot. It's been probably 3, maybe not.
Oh my gosh.
What do you do? You have to get BKB. Or Shadow Blade or Blink or something.
Yeah.
BKB is by far the safest.
No, I just, yeah, found by the, I'm on the Chaos Knight, and the chaos ensues. He goes down, so it's a tough game for Mickey here. Again, he almost has the BKB finished, but obviously not having it there, so slowing down. He talked about the Blink Dagger on Slaughter. He actually almost does have that now. He's also level 10 just about, but finally we'll get it, but it's not like they have the Lifestealer Bomb to go with it. It's just going to be a decent initiation tool here.
I don't really have any follow-up, though. Kind of sucks.
That's true.
Done into... question mark?
Into Requiem, I guess, would be ideal. Maybe with like a Shadowblade initiation, yeah. But obviously that's a ways off, as we keep looking at here, so... Now you're right, though. Yeah, the follow-up does seem fairly weak, for sure. At this point, at least, and they're gonna take out Roshan here in the meantime.
Aw, yeah, Puffy Solar Crest.
He likes it too.
Solar Crest is so good. It completely counters level 1 Amplify. Or, yeah, level 1 Crows of Haze.
Okay.
And probably level 2 as well, because of the evasion. It's also just really good for like this. He actually died a.
Yeah, it's obviously great for a hero like this too. It's kind of being sneaky in the back lines here and trying to amp that damage up for quick kills, or you know, even help teammates if it calls for it. So definitely seems like overall a great tool, and I know it did get some buffs recently too. So
yeah, that item is so much value now. Oh my goodness, I actually think that item is very good.
Okay, trying to run them down. He's not too afraid. He does have that BKB now. Slaughter jumped in, but he gets stunned immediately. The reality rip pulling, and he just melts in a matter of seconds. You see the three Phantasms are out. The Requiem of Souls, he gets it off, but it's just too late. He dies right after. The follow-up damage, again, is not really the greatest. A lot of bounces from that Omni Slash, a lot of illusions to bounce to. Mitigating plenty of damage. Another reality rip pull in. It's almost like we got a mini Pudge here of sorts, just pulling everyone in.
They didn't have any way. They can't clear the illusions. Like, those just destroyed the CK during the Requiem. That was sad. Or during the BKB, rather.
Yeah. Shadow Fiend melted, and the rest followed, obviously, yeah, as we saw. So Team Secret, all the momentum in the world at this point, and you always like, in cases like this, obviously, you like to try to give hope for the other side of Pro Dota, and where's the comeback mechanic, but it's looking grim.
One of the things that they didn't prepare for well is the lack of AoE. They didn't have AoE in their draft, and they also didn't prepare for it in their item build. Juggernaut, we talked about it last time, that Kamadon build, that's a good item, but it's not always a build. And this game, yeah. I also think it was the build. I think like Battle Fury or Maelstrom is kind of imperative on this hero against this Chaos Knight, or else you're always just going to be destroyed. Like, how are you going to Omni Slash and do those like really tanky illusions? You have to be able to clear them somehow, and Requiem is simply not enough.
A soldier's vengeance.
Not wasn't an easy game for them to begin with because of the draft. No AoE versus CK and giving up Keeper, I think, are just really big mistakes in the draft. But again, it can be compensated through by good play, like not giving up 10 plus track kills,
yeah,
and building some AoE. But maybe soon, maybe Juggernaut will be able to get it after his Mantis style. But right now, it is looking like the gold lead is getting close to that point where Pro Dota can't even go outside the base, even during Night.
Oh, with that said, he does have the Axe. He does have a gem now he just purchased on the Night Stalker, that is, so.
Yeah, maybe they can kill the... I mean, he's pretty tanky, though.
Like, that's true.
1200 HP and Solar Crest is... like, it's not easy to kill him at all.
like kind of attempt right there, but not really. It's just a quick stun and then fallback.
Yeah.
From Slaughter.
If they had like Blink BKB Black Hole on Enigma, there is very little chance of. But he went Greaves and went into a Midas afterwards. I wonder if he's gonna get cooldown reduction or G.
Cooldown reduction just seems like overall one of the best talents to get at like any hero.
It is. But he hasn't used Black Hole like before once. It's
true.
So
it does also affect items though, and I think that's why one of the reasons that makes it so good.
Oh, I mean, I'm totally on board.
Yeah.
However, this game they're not really fighting that much.
True.
So I think like if he has Blink BKB, he can actually get off the Black Holes. I don't know. It's cooldown reduction. I would say you can never really go wrong with cooldown
reduction.
I'm never gonna say that's a bad decision.
Neither one's going to be a bad decision here.
Neither one's going to be a bad decision.
Safe to say. Oh, Riyadh.
Oh, my
well,
God.
Rubick no longer exists right now. Mega kill streak for MP, and this tower push is going to be pretty easy. Again, Enigma Black Hole is a threat here, so they want to be careful about committing to a fight.
They have to do something, though.
Nice silence. Well, maybe not, I mean, maybe they are comfortable enough to say, you know what, you're going to have one of our racks. That's inevitably going to happen. Now, they want to kind of fight right here. The stun initiation on the Chaos Knight. Illusions are still up though, and the Melee Rax is going to be dropping right here most likely. There goes a BKB pop, jumps onto the Shadow Fiend, and once again just melts. He doesn't have his own BKB, buys back immediately though, and the BKB is coming up in 10 seconds. Darkness has fallen now. The chase down, the Crush going to miss right there. He actually went in, but he got stopped with the Blink Dagger, I believe, and thus the Crush was not able to connect. Chaos Knight thrown in the air, but again, he has the Aegis, so worst case he dies right here. He's coming right back up anyways. Not necessarily that big of a deal. Garter bouncing around with the Omni Touch. There's the Black Hole going off. It's not going to be stopped. The counter Black Hole, actually, from Insania coming out, though. So maybe give them a shot. In comes the Requiem of Souls. And down goes, actually, Chaos Knight. He's going to come back up, though, as mentioned. Garter will tear through the Ember Spirit. And now Chaos Knight, all of a sudden, he is in a pretty vulnerable spot. He may end up falling right here. As a spin on top of it, going for the perhaps turn kill. The Bolt comes out. The Illuminate through. Not going to be enough. And down goes Chaos Knight. Right.
Oh, man. That's one of those fights where the Rubick plays a better Enigma than your Enigma.
Zania over Kezu.
Kezu is not my favorite player. But that was not... It wasn't... Like, that Black Hole was not necessary at all. Maybe he thought he was going to get a few more on the sidelines.
Yeah.
But one of the problems is he did go... Is he going for a heart afterwards of the Enigma? Is that for real? That cannot be.
Heart. Wow. Yeah, that is curious.
Okay. Yeah. That what? I'm looking. Okay. Yeah. It's right next to Octarine Core on the shop.
Yeah, he's clicking through. He now has a Lincoln's queued up. So, yeah, the heart would have been pretty odd for sure.
Yeah.
Not going for that here.
That fight should have been way easier. I think if they just don't use Black Hole, they would have been better off. Rubick does not have a blink. Like, he just has to sit there and just wait for the hole. And that's exactly what he did because Kezu played into it. But, I mean, they blew out the Shadow Fiend. They got the melee Renax. They got the buyback on him. It'll not be end of the game, I would say. Like, if that fight went cleanly, they could just steamroll through to another rank. But now they're actually still going to have to play pretty cautiously.
They give the other team a little bit of hope, is essentially getting out there. And yeah, that's still pro Dota. They have a reason to continue on and continue to play here. In fact, a pickoff on a Chaos Knight once again would be more than enough of another reason, but there's a Phantasm, and with that BKB, just goes in on to Slaughter, and that's a quick kill as a result. The reality of pulling Coddle, meanwhile, he's going to run away though with a Blinding Light pushback because it has that support coming in. They know this, but they cannot get away in time. Down goes the Sania, and there's another kill onto the Night Stalker, and the Requiem of Souls not going to be nearly enough. It will mitigate their damage a little bit, but it's still gonna fall, so triple kill for MP.
Shadow Fiend seems so useless. I don't know what would have been a better pick than Shadow Fiend.
You're right, yeah.
It's like, they needed a hero with AUE that does decently in mid versus Ember, but Shadow Fiend is like, he's just been getting wailed on by Chaos Knight all game, and his game did not go that badly. They ganked, they killed the Ember like two or three times, so it's definitely not like a player skill thing. My eyes.
No, I don't think that is either, yeah.
It's just weird that he just ended up being so useless. Same with the Slaughter. Like, I've never seen a Slaughter with a blink be like, that's not gonna, like, it's
just
useless.
Nothing.
It doesn't do anything for his team, which is weird.
Yeah.
Because usually it's like, oh my god, Slaughter has blink. But this game, whatever.
The follow-up wasn't there. I mean, that early game did start to get a little bit out of control, and I think it's just, we're just also seeing that. The scaling is just so much better at this point. I mean, look at that, the Omni Slash. Just did nothing, basically.
That's sad.
Might as well not even use it. The Omni Slash hurt him more than helped him in that case, and This is going to be another melee act, and I think this is the beginning of the end now for Team Secret.
Yep.
Again, as I like to say, taking care of business, as they no doubt were the favorites here. Gonna take the game off of Pro Dota Gaming. So, I mean, PD, though, this is a team, again, they qualified out of the open qualifiers, and you're facing one of the favorites here in Team Secret right off the bat. They gave a little bit of justification as to maybe why their team to look out for somewhat, but...
Their team play was not bad at all in the mid game. I just think you have to take Keeper first over Sardar in 100% of cases. Even if you don't have a Keeper player, I still think you could do it. Like, the hero is just too...
If you don't have a Keeper player, then you ban it. I think it's the other point. Take it away as an option, perhaps. But yeah, that's going to be a GG well play being called, and it's official. Team Secret will start 1-0 here in the group stages. So again, doing their job and taking the victory over Pro Dota. But again, a lot of matches to play, so don't look too much into this over these next couple of days right here. But still a strong start for Secret. So final thoughts on the game before we move on here?
It worked out really well.